So now we turn to this idea of, you know, guarding one's privates within marriage. Before a young man gets married in our times nowadays, you know, they've watched a few movies here and there before they made tawbah and they became religious, and they have this idea of what love is and what marriage is. And, you know, brothers come up to me all the time, "Brother, man, I gotta get married, man." You know, as though, like, in their head, once they get married, all their temptations are just gonna poof, disappear, and life is gonna be bliss, and we're gonna read Quran together, you know, and, you know, it's gonna be just a spiritual experience, right? And there's this fantastic view of what marriage really is. Those of you that are married are probably not even laughing right now, because they're like, what? Because, what is he talking about? Because you don't even remember feeling that way, right? So, yeah, it's many a times you do run into a brick wall, because what is shown to us about marriage, our idea of marriage, especially the modern mind, whether Muslim or otherwise, the modern idea of love and companionship and a man and a woman together, the idea of it is basically the same as dating, okay? And dating means you have all the fun, and when things get difficult, you walk away. That's what dating is, right? So what we actually, when we think of marriage, men, brothers and sisters even, when they think of marriage, they're thinking of the aspects of marriage that are like dating. But you know, there's a lot more to marriage than dating, right? There's the bills, and there's the chores, and then there's you have to learn to live with another person, which is very difficult. You do things your way, she does things her way, and now there's a towel hanging the wrong way, or the toothbrush is in a different place, or, you know, something, there's a little too little sugar in your coffee or something, or little things start adding up and start, in the beginning, I love her too much, I'm not going to say anything, I can handle this. But a couple of years later, it starts piling up, and you're like, again with the sugar, you know, and it starts adding up. Now, this doesn't happen in dating, because you're tired of this girl, move on to the next one. Or she's tired of you, I think, you know, I don't want to deal with your smell anymore, I'm out. You know, it's just walk away from it. But marriage is a serious commitment. And you know, the terminology used in Quran is very strong. Al-muhsanat, al-muhsineen. You know what a muhsin is? You know, the ihsan, in Arabic, it's the word used for putting someone inside a fort, like a military camp. The idea of that is there are enemies outside. Once you're inside this military facility, you're safe, right? So women are told, are described as women, are females that have been put inside the camp of protection. And who's protecting them? The husband is. From everything, from sadness, from difficulty, from shamelessness, in terms of ignorance, he's protecting them, he's giving them an education, he's protecting them in every single way. And the one who wants to get married, Allah describes him, muhsineen ghayra musafihin. They are people who, they are men who have the intention of bringing women into this fort, into their protection, to start families, not just to get their desires.